Russia's world largest submarine Typhoon class, Borei-A, newest to require nuclear submarine. The nuclear weapons submarine. Russia's massive Typhoon class ballistic missile submarine is now the world's largest submarine. It's big, but if Russian engineers get their way, it might be dwarfed. The Pilgrim, a massive submarine tanker, has been suggested to transport liquid natural gas, LNG, in the Arctic. Submarine tankers will literally disappear beneath the ice. The world's largest submarines were built at Soviet shipyards, not American ones. These Cold War leviathans, named after sharks, could destroy up 200 targets with bombs 6 times as destructive as those that erupted over Hiroshima. The Typhoon-class submarines, also known as the Akula-class submarines, were among the most deadly weapons ever devised. The Akula shark-class, or Project 941, during development, was intended to serve as the foundation for the Soviet Union's naval nuclear deterrent forces. The Soviet Union had learned of the United States Navy's planned Ohio-class fleet ballistic missile submarines, which would measure 564 feet in length and 76 feet wide and almost 38 feet tall, and carry 192 nuclear bombs. The Soviet leadership determined that it needed its own submarine to counter the looming menace, and thus the Akula class was developed. Malachite Design Bureau, based in St. Petersburg, has produced a concept for a huge submarine capable of carrying 170,000 to 180,000 tons at a time. That is significantly more than any prior submarine's volume. People who work on the Typhoon class can live in 19 different rooms that can hold 160 people. It would be fueled by no fewer than 3 nuclear reactors, each producing 30 megawatts, to move this enormous mass. This may push it at a speed of 17 knots, just a few knots slower than conventional tankers. Due to the fact that this is not a combat vessel, the crew would be quite modest by submarine standards, around 25 to 28 individuals. It would take 3 nuclear reactors, each rated at 30 megawatts, to move this massive amount of weight 17 knots, which is only a few knots slower than normal tanker speeds. Is possible with this? Due to the fact that it isn't a vessel, the crew size would be small, around 25 to 28 individuals. The number of typhoons are dwindling. It has been around for a long time. Dmitry Donskoy was the first of the type to enter service in 1981. Only Dmitry Donskoy, one of the 5 Typhoon class ships built, is still in service. Arms limitation accords forced the retirement of the others. Russians are now acquiring Borei class to replace the Dmitry Donskoy, and the Typhoon class will eventually be withdrawn. The new Borei class. According to some stories, the Donskoy joined the Borei class after undergoing a significant refit and surviving to fight another day. In 2019, there was further speculation in Russian military propaganda organizations that 2 additional Typhoon class submarines might be repurposed into carriers for 200 Kalibr cruise missiles. The objective was to stay ahead of American Ohio class submarines, which are capable of carrying 154 Tomahawk cruise missiles. This proved to be an optimistic estimate due to cost concerns and technical difficulties associated with the renovation. It's a matter of economics. The Dmitry Donskoy is a costly ship to maintain because of its size and age. For the cost of maintaining the Donskoy, the Russians may manufacture new Borei-class submarines. It is probably preferable for the Donskoy to be used solely for missile testing rather than undergo a certain overhaul in order to join the new Borei-class. You have to give the Russians credit for building such a big submarine and equipping it with amenities such as a pool and a sauna. It's wonderful for the crew to be able to let off steam after being buried for 120 days. Latest Borei class arrives in Russia's north and transit to Pacific Fleet. February 1st, 2022, the Project 955A Borei-A, latest strategic nuclear-powered submarine, Knyaz Oleg arrived at Russia's Northern Fleet during its interfleet transit to the Pacific Fleet for operational service. It was laid down on July 27, 2014 and floated out on July 16, 2020. As part of state trials, the nuclear-powered submarine successfully test-fired a Bulava intercontinental ballistic missile from the White Sea towards the Kura Proving Ground on the Kamchatka Peninsula on October 21, 2021. Compared to the baseline Borei series, Borei-A subs feature better acoustic stealth, maneuvering and deep sea running capabilities, and an improved armament control system. So viewers, hope this video will be helpful. Thank you for watching.